at this point, Mayweather was raining right hands on him, and the right hand of Mayweather, which is a very accurate punch anyway, just continues to land.
And this is the inexperience of McGregor, too. Yeah. He doesn't know how to survive, doesn't know how to hold, doesn't know how to survive even when he's hurt and tired. There's ways you can play possum or even survive. Conor was just taking shots flush.
And he has other ways in MMA to survive, but here
Conor McGregor did a good
job. He's in all kinds of trouble here. The right hand of Mayweather is like a laser beam. And I mentioned the 20 of 25 power shots landed right at the end of Robert Burns. And no complaint from McGregor about the stoppage.
McGregor took on the best of the best. I would say, is there a future for him in boxing after this out?
I don't know. That's something else to discuss. But right now, I think that Mayweather is showing us that even though this was a slightly imperfect performance,
I didn't realize
by
how big
early,
Conor McGregor was.
He came out and did the thing he needed
big,
to do in this fight.
His arms
are
long as shit.
Floyd Mayweather,
the dude
McGregor,
is big.
The
they said he came in
a lot of power punches.
Had like
he
almost 180 pounds tonight. So the dude was a big dude, man.
And ultimately, we mentioned 25 minutes had been the longest he had been in the octagon,
and you have,
this was well past.
And you have to stop this fight. McGregor hadn't thrown a punch in about a minute here. You know what I'm saying? So even if not every shot's landing clean, it was an assault right there. You have to stop it. McGregor was not returning fire.
He did a good job. Respect to Conor McGregor. Crossing sports.
And at the end, we see now that mixing in the left hook. We didn't see that many from Mayweather during the course of this fight. He mixed them in. Mostly it was the right hand that did the damage. And McGregor is so fatigued at this juncture. What a heart Conor McGregor has, but MMA fans know that from watching him perform in the octagon.
Well, I guess that's for the people who say Floyd didn't get a knockout in a while.
At the age of 40, comes out of retirement and does what, well, a lot of people expected him to do to beat Conor McGregor. But for Conor McGregor, this was expected to be an egregious mismatch. I'm wondering how many people now, well, are upset that they missed this match. It was fun.
It was fun.
This was a good fight, though. This was entertaining. They made this entertaining.
Look at the numbers. 58% of the power punches landed by
they made it very entertaining.
Final show stats brought to you by Corona Extra. And with the official announcement here, once again, the classy Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 1:05 in round number 10. Our referee stops the contest. He is the winner by way of technical knockout and still undefeated, Floyd Money Mayweather.
The money belt goes to Money
Floyd had to come forward in a lot of this fight. You know, he really was trying, going for the knockout.
All right, thank you very much, Moro. Floyd, congratulations on this fight. You guys just had an exchange of words talking to each other. What did he say? What did you say back?
We talked about he's a tough competitor, and I think we gave the fans what they wanted to see. I told him that I owe them for the Pacquiao fight. I must come straight ahead and give the fans a show. And I think that's what I gave him.
Was he better than you?
He gave a show,
he's
man.
He's a lot better than I thought he was. He used different angles. He was a tough competitor, but I was the better man tonight.
Was it awkward for you in the first several rounds? First three rounds seemed as though you lost and were off to a slow start. Were you just trying to figure him out, or was he just better in those rounds?
No, that was our game plan. Our game plan was to take our time, go to him, let him shoot all his heavy shots early, and then take him out at the end, down the stretch.
Floyd, you seem to come to life and figure this out. Did he seem tired to you as he got onto the 7th, 8th, and 9th rounds?
Well, that was our game plan. Me and my dad talked about it. We wanted him to shoot his heavy shots in the beginning, because we know in the MMA he fight 25 minutes real hard. After 25 minutes, he started to slow down.
In the 9th round, that was your biggest round, if you can remember that, right before the stoppage in the 10th round. When you had him in that 9th round, did you pretty well know at that point that this would be a knockout and it was only just going to be a matter of a few more moments?
Well, if I'm not mistaken, I guaranteed everybody that this fight wouldn't go the distance.
Because you said boxing's reputation was on the line.
Boxing reputation was on the line. Boxing is a hell of a sport. MMA is a hell of a sport. And I want to thank all the fans from Ireland and all the fans around the world that came to this event.
Floyd, you've had a couple years off, 714 days. There's no beating Father Time. Were you a much different fighter this evening, and could you tell that you were age 40?
Well, no, that was our game plan. Our game plan was to go straight ahead. I told you guys in numerous interviews that I would go straight ahead. I wouldn't back up, and that's what I did.
That is what he did.
You said you're not going to talk about 50-0 because it didn't matter to you. Now you're 50-0, does it?
I couldn't do it without the fans.
It doesn't matter.
A win is a win, no matter how you get it.
Does the record 50-0, and you know its significance, fighting 49-0 and now breaking this record or setting this record, does it matter, and what does it mean to you?
Rocky Marciano is a legend, and I just look forward to going down in the Hall of Fame someday. I look forward to you going down in the Hall of Fame also.
Thank you. I appreciate that, Floyd. Your legacy. Will you fight again? If somebody comes and says, here's another $300-400 million, we know you love money, we know you love fighting. You promised Al Haymon this was it, but could you be lured back?
This was my last fight tonight, ladies and gentlemen. My last fight.
That's for certain, no matter what's in front of you.
For sure. Tonight was my last fight, for sure. I chose the right dance partner to dance with. Conor McGregor, you're a hell of a champion. And to the country of Ireland, we love you guys.
Floyd, congratulations. Terrific career.
Great work. Good job. Come on, 10 years, good job. I turned him into a Mexican tonight. He fought like a Mexican.
Conor, how would you assess your performance? I'm sure that other than you, so bear with us, other than you, this is a pretty surprising performance by a man who has never fought a professional boxing.
You did a real good job.
I don't know. I thought I took the early rounds pretty handy. He had to change his style. And fair play to him, he did. He adjusted. He changed his style. Put the hands up more forward. He's composed. He's not that fast. He's not that powerful. But boy, is he composed in there. So he was making me throw, and he was patient with his shots. I've got to give him nothing but respect. Fair play to him. Great career he's had. What can I say? Fuck, I had a bit of fun over on this side. Hopefully entertain the fans on this side. I thought it was close though, and I thought it was a little early of a stoppage. I get like that when I'm tired. I get a little wobbly and flowy. Before getting me into the corner and recovering and I come back, I'd have liked him to hit the floor. I'd have liked the ref to, you know what I mean? There's a lot on the line here. He should have let me keep going, I thought, but fair play though. I'm not gonna.
You're doing it to protect you, probably. You didn't want the protection?
Yeah, I was just a little fatigued. He was a lot more composed under the shots. He was a lot more experienced, especially in the later part of it, but early on I felt like it was handy enough, to be honest. But he's composed in there. They've got to give it to him. That's what 50 pro fights will give you. So fair play to him.
Conor, I may be wrong in this assessment, and tell me, but you seem happy. I know you're not happy to lose, but are you pleased with how you perform?
I don't know. I've been here before. I've been strangled on live TV and came back. So I don't know. I would have liked it to just let it go. Okay. It was some buzz. To get in here, the squared circle, everything was different. There was a lot more fun. I thought it was close. I thought we were close. Don't get me wrong, I get a little wobbly when I'm fatigued, similar to the Diaz Duel fight.
Did you get tired?
That's exactly what it is. It's fatigue. That's why I thought the ref could have just let it keep going. Let me go down. Let the man put me down. Like, wobbly and fatigue, that's energy. That's not damage. I'm clear-headed.
Will you box again? Would you like to box again?
You see what happens. I don't know. I have two titles. I don't know. I'm having a buzz flowing around. Anyone wants to not give me a show.
And will you go back to the UFC and fight again?
Of course.
At the rates you were fighting for before, after you made so much money now, or have you changed the paradigm for MMA fighters?
The game changes every time we grow and we see what's what. But whatever, I thought it was close. I thought I had him in the early rounds. I thought he was getting in the middle towards the end. Where was the final two rounds? Let me wobble back to my corner. Let me try and recompose myself. You know what I mean? You've got to put me out. I'm brand new, I'm clear spoken. It's not bothering me, so I don't know what way to feel, to be honest. I'm just happy I'm draping the flag. Happy I was able to bring my team along, the country with me. I'm just getting to perform for a different crowd. No one's taking these type of risks. So fuck it, he's going to lay into me all he's want. I'll take it on the chin. I'll take it wrapped around the neck and on live TV. I've took them both, so it's another day for me.
Conor, thank you. Enjoyed it.
Thanks so much. Have a good night, Jim. Thank you.
Appreciate it. All right, Marlon, back to you.
All right, thank you very much, Jim. Gracious in victory, Floyd. Mayweather, Conor McGregor.
Well, all in all, you did a good job, Conor McGregor. Congratulations to Floyd Mayweather on getting the W. You know, he did what he was supposed to do at the end of the day. He was a lot tougher than I believe most people thought it was going to be for Floyd. You know, most boxing fans, people know the sport. I'm a little surprised by how big Conor McGregor was in comparison to Floyd Mayweather, how much longer his reach was, and, you know, I'm also surprised a little bit by the way Floyd fought. He fought coming forward on his front foot. He fought, you know, he endorsed the whole toe-to-toe thing that he said he wanted to do in other fights and things like that, so... You know, we got that in this
so
fight.
After the money fight,
it was a good fight, man. A good entertaining fight. A good night for boxing. A good night for MMA. I think everybody won tonight. Fans got their money worth. These two dudes got paid out the ass. The UFC is happy they got their bread. Alan's happy they got their bread. Everybody happy. Everybody happy. I think it was just a good night overall. Conor McGregor will probably go back to the UFC and go fight. And Floyd Mayweather will retire into the sunset.
Did a very, very good job.
Anyway, man, post-fight review coming tomorrow, man. Let me know y'all thoughts, man. Hit it up in the comment section below and all that shit. Until next time, I'll let you motherfucking boy.